Okay, now we're back at the bench over at the layout block. And if you recall, I etched a line or scratched or scribed a line across all of the planes that we'll be drilling with. So the next step was, since I've got the center line that now I know is the same plane as this, and I know if this is at 90 degrees now, and I checked the plans, and the measure is 3 1/4 inches from the face of this to the center of that, or the center of the bearing block. And the way that I did this is with my machinist square, put that on there like this, and I'm holding it like that. I've got that set on 3 1/4 inches. I come down and I just double checked at the top of that, and that from a visual standpoint certainly looks like it's in the middle of where it needs to be. And then I have scribed a line here on the 4.5 inch mark. So the only thing that remains is to use a square and line up the bottom. Now you begin to see why it's so important to start with square surfaces and everything the same, because we're constantly measuring from this point on with these scribe lines and so forth from standard references such as that bottom. So now the center of this mark is exactly 3 1/4 inches. Now here are the next tools that I'll be using. I've got a very small hammer and an extremely sharp punch. Now, I don't make the initial prick very deep. In fact, I can almost just push it in by hand, especially in this aluminum. And from that point on, I check and double check before I start making any larger marks. So I'm going to do that right now. This is the setup that I'm using. This is the parallel here at the bottom. I've got this white piece of paper so that it might show up a little bit better. But the parallel is going to be my gauge to make sure that the base sits down even. Because right over here, you see, I've still got that engine base mount that's over here. So I have to put something in here. Now I'll go over to the backside and the top view of what's going on here. Right here is where the crankshaft will have to be drilled. And this will have to be a hole that goes through both of these bearings here. Now, it has to be at 90 degrees, or it needs to be in the same plane as what the face is for the cylinder up here. Now, going around to the backside of this angle plate, you can see, or perhaps you can see, there is, let's see if I can get it a little bit better, there is a T nut and a T slot back here, and I've got a grade 8 bolt or a hex head bolt that's going through the middle of the engine that had a space in it. So this is going to hold it all solid to the plate, and I'll show you what it looks like when I get it over to the milling machine in just a moment.